Namaste. Welcome to Anand India channel.
In this video, I will take you to the Narayangarh Fort. The Narayangarh is located at 80 km from Pune, 200 km from Mumbai, 10 km from Narayangarh, near Khodad village. We begin our journey from Pune. This is Pune-Nasik highway. After 70 km from Pune, there is a Narayangarh town. From the state transport bus stop at Narayangarh, take a right towards Khodad village. The road to Khodad village is extremely narrow. Be very careful while driving here. Around 7 km from Narayangarh, take left towards Gadachiwadi village, which is the base village of Narayangarh fort. This is Gadachiwadi village, from where Narayangarh fort is at 1 km. The road after Gadachiwadi is very bad and made up of a soil. In front, you can see the Narayangarh fort. There is ample space available for parking at the base of fort. At the base, there is Goddess Mukai Devi temple. Behind the temple, you can see the steps of Narayangarh fort. The Narayangarh fort is built in Satavahana era and it is used as a watchtower for the Jinnar Python trade route. The fortification of the fort was rebuilt by 1st Peshwa Balaji Vishwanath in 1720. The stairs of the fort are destroyed by British after 1818. Recently, these stairs are rebuilt. Also, the government has installed railings at difficult stages. The fort height is at 876 meters from sea level. It takes 20 minutes to reach on Narayangarh fort from the base. You can see the zigzag stairs of the fort. The entrance gate of the fort was lost during the period of time. You can see remains of fortification near the entrance of the fort. The remains of the fortification can be seen around all the periphery of the fort. The fort has natural protection by the steep cliffs on the sides. On the way to the Hastamata temple, there is an old historic water storage tank. Near the Hastamata temple, there are remains of old building which is said to belong to the head of the fort called Killedar in Marathi. There you can see a pot made up of a solid basalt stone. Near the building, there are remains of a door frame on which you can see sculpture of a Lord Ganesha. This rectangular piece is called as Ganeshpatti in Marathi. This is the statue of a Sharap, which is a lion-looking animal having wings like birds, described in Hindu mythology. It is carved near the entrance gates of important buildings to protect it from devil powers. There is one small water tank built near the goddess Hastamata temple. The Hastamata temple is highest point on Narayangarh fort. Inside temple, there is a statue of goddess Hastamata, worshipped by local villagers. Let's go back to the other side of the fort. From Hastamata temple, around 300 meters, there is a big water reservoir known as Narayan Takur. From Narayan Takur, you can have beautiful view of surrounding. On the other side of fort, there is a seven cistern called Saptamatruka, a pattern of water storage tanks. The seven water tanks represent seven different form of goddess, each represents female counterpart of a god. Here I have mentioned the names of seven goddesses. Near the seven cistern there is another water tank. The stones extracted from this water tank are used to build the fortification of Narayangarh fort. From the fort you can see the giant dish shaped structures, which are the part of giant meter wave radio telescope. There are total 30 fully steerable parabolic radio telescopes in this area. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to click on that like button. Thank you for watching. You can follow Unknown India channel on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. Hit the red button to subscribe and press the bell icon on YouTube app and you will never miss another update.